Welcome to Java Forum. Today we are going to see how to install Jenkins 2.3 RPM file, which is already downloaded from Jenkins website. So Jenkins 2.32 is a long-term support release. So before I proceed the install, so this is the basic information about this machine. So this is CentOS 6.10 virtual machine. So now we are going to check Jenkins will be fit to CentOS 6.10 or not. So this is Jenkins 2.32 long-term support RPM version, which I already downloaded. So I am going to install this RPM. So to install this RPM, I should log in as a root user. So before that, I check whether Java is available or not. So java-version will come and which Java is installed. So OpenJDK 1.7 is already available. So OpenJDK 1.7 is bundled with the CentOS 6.10 release. So no need to separately install Java. So Jenkins 2.32 supports OpenJDK 7. So now I am going to start the install. So logged in as a administrator user now. RPM hyphen IVH Jenkins package name, RPM package name. So this is the installation command. So now the Jenkins installation was successful. Now I am going to query the package name rpm-qa-grub-jenkins. So this is the package name which is installed now, which will be useful in future. So an rpm-ql-jenkins will give the list of directories and files used by the Jenkins RPM package. So these are the list of directories and files. And in /usr/lib/jenkins, the Jenkins var is installed. So this Jenkins var is run by Jetty web server, which is inbuilt in the RPM. So now I am going to cd /var/lib/jenkins. So this will be the Jenkins home directory, so where all the configuration files will be created. So currently there is no files in this directory. So once I have start the Jenkins, some files will be created in /var/lib/jenkins. So Jenkins is started now. So now I am going to access the Jenkins. So it will be running in the port 8080. So a temporary password has been generated in the location /var/lib/jenkins. So I am going to cat that file. So cat command, using cat command. So here you can see some of the configuration files are created. So using cat command, I am getting the password. This is a temporary administrator password generated. So I am copying this. Yes. So now I am going to create the first admin user for Jenkins. So this is the offline installation. Without internet, we are installing the Jenkins now. Yes. So Jenkins is ready now, and I have logged in as a Jenkins user, which I have created now. So this will be the administrator user. So we are navigating the Jenkins URL available now. So this is about Jenkins software. So Jenkins 2.3.2.3 is a long-term support release, and these are the third-party libraries, plugins, which is used by this current version. So in upcoming tutorials, we see a lot about Jenkins. So this is the installation and configuration tutorial. So now I'm going to show how to stop and start the Jenkins. Service Jenkins stop. So this is the command used to stop the Jenkins. So now you can see Jenkins is stopped. So again, I am starting the Jenkins using service Jenkins start. Okay, now I am going to watch the logs. So cd /var/log/Jenkins. So this is the directory where Jenkins log files are generated. So I am checking the log files for any startup issues or any detail I want needed. I can see the Jenkins log, which is generated here. So now installation, Jenkins installation was successful. Now I'm going to uninstall the Jenkins. So before that, I am stopping the Jenkins. So it's running now. Jenkins is running now. So I need to stop that one. Jenkins is stopped now. So first, I am going to query the package details. So rpm-qa grub Jenkins give the package name. So rpm-ql Jenkins will give the list of files used by the Jenkins softwares, list of files and directories. So first, I am going to uninstall using the rpm erase command. So Jenkins 2.32 was uninstalled successfully, but some of the residual packages, that is some of the residual files will be remaining. So I am deleting those directories and files also. So this will be the complete 100% removal of Jenkins. So if you plan for upgrade, you no need to remove this file. If you plan for a fresh install or planned for a removal, so this is the method to remove Jenkins 100% from your CentOS 6.10. So now removal of or uninstall of Jenkins 2.32 long-term support was successful. So in this video, we have learned how to install Jenkins using RPM package and how to run Jenkins, how to create the Jenkins admin user using the temporarily generated password, and how to watch the logs, and finally how to uninstall the Jenkins. So subscribe our YouTube channel for more videos. So a lot of tutorials, lot of Java latest software tutorials are yet to come. So we need your support. So subscribe our YouTube channel Java FRM. Stay tuned for a lot of updates yet to come. Goodbye.